RTX 3070 is delayed, but we have more performance numbers to look at. Huh? Time travel mathematically, and now we have VR boots to kill motion problems. Don't go anywhere. This is... You are probably waiting for the RTX 3070 because of its lower price tag, but today I have some bad news for you. After the drama surrounding RTX 3080 and its shortage around the world, Nvidia has announced that the release of RTX 3070 will be postponed until 29th of October. According to Nvidia, the purpose of this move is to help our global partners get more graphics cards into the hands of gamers on launch day. But the decision of choosing this day is rather interesting because it is one day after AMD's big Navi announcement, which is taking place on 28th of October. So is AMD trying to steal the spotlight again? Along with the announcement of the delay, Nvidia also released more charts for the 3070's game performance. It really seems like the RTX 3070 is neck to neck and even beat the 2080 Ti in many applications. Pretty impressive, huh? If independent reviews also show the same results, then I think this card will sell like hotcakes. Will you guys buy one or two because your Tai also needs one? Or are you guys gonna wait for AMD's big Navi lineup announcement? Let us know in the comments below. As we all know, there are many types of wood. Oak, ash, pine, softwood, hardwood. And one thing I wouldn't have expected is that there's a kind of wood that can be made into phone screens. Researchers from Forest Product Laboratory, University of Maryland, University of Colorado have teamed up together to work on this project after they have discovered that balsa wood can be made transparent. In order to make this wood semi-transparent, all they have to do is oxidize it in room temperature. And after that, they will add a kind of synthetic polymer into it to make it more glass-like. Also, the glass is more durable and much lighter compared to regular glass. Another wow factor is that this glass is bendable, which is great considering the upcoming trend of foldable smartphones. And lastly, this glass when mass produced is much cheaper than regular glass. Woo! And in case if you're wondering what happens to this glass when it falls onto the floor, well, it doesn't break, it splinters! What do you think about this new discovery? With the anti-plastic movement, will this discovery cause more harm to our planet in the long run? Let us know in the comments down below. Our planet seems to be getting more and more dangerous lately. With all the wildfires and bushfires that happened last year, floods, earthquakes, Beirut explosion, and of course the ongoing pandemic. Well, I won't be surprised if in the future we have to wear a gas mask to go out. Apple seems to be gearing up for a safer future because they are working on a type of phone sensor that, according to the patent filing, uses laser to detect any harmful particles in the air, such as poisonous gas, pollen, or any other things that are harmful for our health. In the patent, the lasers can apparently identify the speed and direction of airflow and perform independent measurements of particulate matter flowing with the air. Wow, imagine when it's paired with a good companion app that shows air quality reports and can alert users of any dangerous elements in the air. But because it is Apple, it is hashtag not cheap, also buy. What do you think about this feature? Need or no need? And it really does seem like our phones are evolving into something that is more of a necessity in our lives. Wouldn't it be cool to walk around in VR games? Well, guess what? An American company, Ecto VR, developed a pair of VR boots known as Ecto 1, which allows players to strut around in-game. But how does it work? These custom-designed boots are made from carbon fiber and feature HTC's Vive trackers to track physical movement and register them into VR. When you place your foot on the ground, a set of wheels will pull your leg backwards as you walk forward. So you can keep walking, but you remain in the same spot. And here is what it looks like on a robot. These boots will potentially be available for consumers in 2 to 4 years time. Right now, the company is only targeting enterprises. I have a concern though. If you're only allowed to move as slowly as a robot in the video just now, how are we gonna run away from zombies or from any dangerous situations in games? Whoa. Will the weight of the boots actually make the players panic and be more paranoid in game? Is this gonna be good for their mental health? How many of you guys wish that you could travel back in time? Well, a group of Australian scientists claim to have proven the possibility of time travel. But how then? By using logic, or more specifically, mathematical modeling. So we all know that Einstein's theory allows people to time travel, but this theory is problematic. For example, if somebody travels back in time to kill his grandfather, then this would cancel out the person's existence in the first place. And this logical problem is what created the grandfather's paradox. But according to Australian scientists, the range of mathematical processes we discovered show that time travel with free will is logically possible in our universe without any paradox. However, the science of dynamics would mean that the fundamental sequence of events could not be interfered with. Here's what it means. If you travel back in time to prevent patient zero from getting infected with COVID-19, then the strings of events that lead up to the pandemic will only readjust and you or someone else could become patient zero instead. This is because the outcome cannot be changed. And with this, the grandfather paradox is mathematically solved. It isn't solved by putting numbers and writing out formulas, okay? It is solved by putting theories together and see how they coexist. So long story short, time traveling cannot change the outcome of your current situation. What we can do is set goals, have a dream, dream as big as you want, and then focus on the present to work towards that dream. It's comments time and I'll pass it to Puds.
Moving on to the comments section. Kenji, actually first lol, I hate myself for this comment but never gonna happen again. That's kinda weird, but hey, you're first here in this video as well, so remember you're always a winner, okay? Don't hate yourself so much, okay? B3NNZ Gaming, is that Ben's Gaming? Is that 0.02 Mashimaro? You mean him? He's not Mashimaro, he's Boo Boo, okay? Boo Boo, like Michelle said it in the other episode. Genji Herrera said, I wish to have a gaming PC in my birthday. I'm pretty sure you are able to get a gaming PC on your birthday, okay? Give you good luck, okay? Salvan Singh said, Michelle is becoming prettier. Aww. Hafiz Abdullah said, is it me or just what? I hardly can understand because the accent is so thick. Sorry. Huh? Really? Is it that thick? Well, if you cannot understand, I guess that's why we have... Faiz Nordin said, aren't Ryzen 7 are too overkill for gaming purposes? All these Ryzen top-end processors, if not for gaming, what are you going to use it for? To watch Netflix, huh? Finally, a shout out to everyone who sent comments about tech. I know I'm personally not the best person to reply to tech comments, but I will highlight them here in this comment section. So here you go. Ding, 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 ding. Hopefully Shane will get back to you soon, either in the comment section or he's gonna pop in the next video to talk about it. So that's it for this episode of MLM. Michelle is not here, but you know what? Pretty sure she's smiling far away in the background, smiling and being proud. Thank you for watching MLM, and that's all for today's episode. Bye. Wait, make me disappear. I'm gone.